happening. No gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what is up, you guys? It's CraftFires here, back with another video. And today, we are back on MAF MV2. Just finished loading up the map. So we're going to go ahead and get started here. Wrong button. Let's go back to this guy. That preheating. And do that. This guy. Okay, so many people have told me that I need to get a grain cart. Well, as you can see right now, that's kind of not possible because we only have $21,000. But I myself am actually wanting a grain cart because this whole crazy yield stuff is driving me absolutely nuts. So, we're gonna do some things here with Bank of Hagenstedt. So, we are going to take out our $200,000 loan, and that is going to give me enough money for a grain cart. Now, we have tractors that will run this grain cart, so we don't have to worry about that. So, what we're gonna do here is we're going to get our truck set up on course play right now. Start course recording. Drive over here to the bin. This is just going to be a temporary course for now. We'll delete it once we're done with this field, but okay, and then we'll go like this. This thing definitely has quite a large acceleration. And we will drive back to the field. See, I just installed Bank of Hagenstedt again, as well as a few other mods. I downloaded a couple of Big Boss modding items, a couple of bale spears, and a pack of combines, of cat combines to be exact. So, drive course. Hopefully, this guy works with course play. Yes, he does. Okay, so. Temp F9 truck. Because we are in field 9, correct? Yes. Okay, so now we are going to go to 1570 here. We're going to unhook that. And now, we need to go to the dealership here. First things first, we're going to buy a set of duals for this tractor. Oh, these tractors are way up here. I totally went past them. So what's the difference between the 1570 and 1370 duals? Probably nothing. So we're going to buy those duals. And we're going to go over here to Tippers and buy the Sestery. 19,000 liter grain cart. This is another mod that I just downloaded. This requires a tractor with 140 plus horsepower, and our 1570 here is 152. So then we're just gonna have the dealership deliver those for us, because that is quite a long haul. Now comes the fun part of trying to get the duals hooked up. It's always a pain in the butt to find the right spot. There we go. Got it. So we'll get hooked onto the grain cart here. Actually, we better move the dual case first. I know just the place to put it. Let's get this set up a little faster. Four is the max that we can go. Spirit 76. Right there ought to do it. Okay, so now we will go ahead and get hooked on to the grain cart here. And then we'll head over to the field, get a course play course set up for it. And then we'll be all set. Let's see, V, open rain plane. That is one of my favorite features of this grain cart. So we'll snap a screenshot of the new grain cart. And then, like I said, we will go ahead and roll to the field. So we will definitely keep this tractor busy. It's as fast as the combine fills. And so B is the pipe. I believe this has some mouse controls on it. PJN. Whatever. There's no power lines, so we don't have to worry about hitting anything. Okay, so that will return to the position that we set it up at. So right now, everything is empty, which is good. That is good, good, good. Okay, and start recording. So we'll head over here to the grain cart, or to the truck, I mean, with the grain cart. And set a waypoint. And stop recording. Overloader, set that to manual. The axial flow, start at 50%, drive on at 100. Save, F9, temp, cart, drive course. Waiting until fill level is reached. Okay. Oof, we've drunk a little bit of fuel sitting there, so anyway, get back to some harvest. So let's get him out of the way. Come on, green cart, get out of the way. Okay, so now he can just sit there. Cause he's out of our way. Yeah, the combine, when I was opening up this end of the field, it definitely did not like that hill. Not at all. It was sliding around all over the place. Okay, so now we can have him come over. And he can unload us on the way back. I'll have to drive a little slower on the way back until he gets over there. So we can make it over here before he... get turned around before he comes. But yeah, we're in good shape here. We just gotta get away from this fence, otherwise he's going to ram straight into it. Turn. Go figure. Oh man. Dumb course play drivers. You have got to be kidding me. Actually, no, I wanted to keep that out. We're gonna unload while we're sitting here. That is not what I had in mind for unloading, but I just want to unload enough so that way I can combine a little bit once we get this thing unstuck. Oh man, that sucks. Should have known he was gonna do that. Courseplay is not the most intelligent of people. That is for sure. Come on. Wonder if I can't take the pickup and get in there. Really? I got the combine hooked on the fence. Come on, let's go. We're gonna run this around and go in there and just ram the crap out of the tractor. Another reason why I'm glad that I do not have damage mod. Ay, ay, ay. The things that happen. Whoa. Okay, time for a head-on collision with this tractor. This tractor would be totaled. Boom. Well, that worked perfectly. Holy crap. Okay, we'll just leave this guy sit. Oh, goodness. Now we have to try and get off of the header. Push, combine, push. Okay, let's put this guy just like this. Get this combine out. That was not what I had in mind. Not at all. put this in this group for now. Okay, drive straight. Yeah, we're pretty much going to fill this grain cart every time that we fill the combine. I want to show up on there. Quest driver. Ah. We'll just have to go to the grain cart. Okay, so let's set him drive on at 95. And drive now. Go run your little course to the truck. Please and thank you. And we will just hang out, make sure that everything works a-okay. Because, as we all know, courseplay at times does not like to be a-okay. There we go. We're up on the crane. We're on the hopper trailer. So now we're pretty much back where we were with money. Down to $29,000, just a little under $30,000. Why are you folding the auger in and out? What in the world? There you go, fold it out. And you could just as well leave the auger out. Whatever. Like on the edge of this thing. And stop. Unload. Cool. RPMs even go way up. Oops. Okay. Now we're all set to go. Get back to some combining. So it looks like it's kind of a tie between square bales and round bales. So, I have to look again, but the last time I looked, it was kind of a tie. So I don't know. I would kind of rather do square bales in a way, but then in a way, I'd rather do round bales. The reason I'd rather do square bales is they're easier to collect than round bales are. They're easier to stack and all that, and plus we'd have a thrower wagon that I haven't tried it out, but I'm pretty sure that it like kind of auto collects them or whatever. So you know, if that's the case, then that's making that even easier. With round bales, we gotta sit and manually stack them, and you know, really I much rather manually stack anything because it's a lot more realistic than an auto stack, but round bales are quite a pain. So I need to stop him because we're getting close to the end of the fence. We don't need another incident like that. At least if we have another incident, the truck is right there. Wait till we get kind of close to this guy and then we'll start him again. And start. Hurry up and get out of the way. Oh, you're gonna cut us off. Go figure. Turn. It's always nervous. Nerve-wracking when that guy goes there. I really should kind of open it up by like two more passes or something, but I think we're okay. Hurry up, green cart. There we go. Just about filled. So, hope everybody enjoyed the ATS video yesterday. I'm actually recording this one day in advance. This video I'm not getting recorded as far in advance as some of the others. I've already got Monday's video recorded. We're working on Tuesday's video, and I've got Wednesday and Friday recorded. So I just need to record one more MAFM V2 episode, and then two more Christmas special videos. So cart is full, so that's gonna fill our truck up quite a ways. Definitely a lot easier to go this way rather than the long way, I guess I'll say, rather than crossways, rather than up and down in this field, because of how the hill is, and going up and down that would be kind of a pain. We still are going to have instances where we're going to fill up, so we'll have to wait for the grain cart, but we won't have to fill up, get the truck, drive it to wherever the combine is, and then once the truck's full, drive all the way to the bins. And the main reason I didn't have a grain cart from the start is because, as you saw, we only had, we had less money than we have now. That's an $80,000 grain cart. And that's the only small grain cart I have at the moment. I had to go looking for it because the only grain carts I have are the Balzer carts, the Kinsey grain carts. Oh, they were full. And then a couple of Brent Avalanches. So there are no grain carts that are small like this. So I had to go and download this one. It's, it's a pretty good size grain cart. It's not too small, not too big. This 1570 runs it perfectly. And we only have like 10 horsepower more than this thing requires, so race over to the combine. I like how he is unfolding and folding the auger, not the combine, the auger on the grain cart here. Normally Courseplay either just leaves it out or doesn't want to put it out. So this guy is 96% and he's heading out. Okay. Back to the combine we go. So we'll unload maybe half the combine right here, and then we'll continue on and then turn around and then call the grain cart again. We can unload going down that way. We are going to have a lot of instances where the grain cart's driving over the crop, but not much I can do about that because this combine's filling and the grain cart Courseplay doesn't like driving only on field. I mean, I could, once I fill up, stop and back up and turn around, but we're stopping then more than we need to, so I would love to avoid having to stop as much as I possibly can. So our truck is empty. Let's see how much wheat we have in storage right now. 326,649 liters, and we still got a ways to go. So in this episode, we'll just kind of be combining, and then the next episode, we'll finish off wheat and get started on beans. Hopefully the beans are as good as this is. I do want to try testing something once. I want to see if maybe I have a combine mod that has sorghum in its mod desk, you know, in its crop types, and then we could buy that combine for when we do sorghum. Oof, we're gonna fill up again here. And there's our truck coming back, ready for another load. This is actually kind of working out perfect, really. The truck's coming back, and by the time he stops, this grain cart will be ready to be on its way over to it. Things are moving nicely. So we are going to fill up the grain cart about the time that we reach, well, pretty soon here. I definitely like the fill plane in that grain cart. That's pretty neat. So we are just going to drive with the auger out, because then we don't have to worry about in and out, in and out, in and out. And we need to go over here to the fuel trailer and fill up pretty soon. We're still pretty good. We're going to run this thing as long as we can. We're going to fill up the combine again and be sitting for a little bit, but that'll kind of start happening more and more as we get farther up the field, especially with longer passes, and then we're farther away from the truck, so the grain cart's got a little bit longer of a trek. I don't think there was ever a rental mod here for 13, but it would be nice, because then we could have just rented two grain carts, and I could have put one on the Puma, and then had, you know, that one running one, and we could have two grain carts running back and forth, so then we'd never have to worry about this. Never have to worry about filling, but this thing takes so long to start up, sometimes it gets annoying. I would love to, this actually is one of the trucks that I am planning on, you know, redoing and putting re-in-gaming for 15. And really, the only stuff that I'm redoing on these models is just separating stuff so that way it works with dirt, and then just re-texturing it, and then re-scripting it, really. That's about all that I'm doing. I'm not, like, rebuilding anything on the model, just basically taking stuff, separating it, joining it, whatever. Making new textures. Ooh, that was a close one. Maybe even on some things, using the existing textures for it. Okay, green cart, come and unload a little bit, please. And stop. So then again, we'll unload about half the combine or so, and then get down to the end, get turned around, and call him back. Which we may not even make it to the end of the field. We'll unload the majority of the combine here. That's good for now. Yeah, we could have put the Puma on there, but that's like a 230 horsepower tractor or something like that. It's a little over 200 horsepower. I can't remember exactly what it is, but it's over 200. So that'd be like, you know, we don't really need that much horsepower on it, but so that's going to do it for this video. What I'm going to do is, I think I might open up the top of the field and kind of work my way down. Yeah, I think I might do that, and then, you know, I will have a bunch more combining done and have it down to the last little bit, and then in the next episode on Thursday, we will finish off this field and get started on soybeans, our final crop for the season. So thanks for watching, you guys. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Make sure to subscribe if you like what you see. Make sure to turn on the post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. Be sure to check out down below in the description for links to all my, for my PC specs, my upload schedule, as well as links to all my social medias, my mod site, and other cool YouTube channels that are worth taking a look at. Thanks for watching, you guys, and as always, we'll see you tomorrow.